This is going to be an extremely important video for you guys. This is not your normal video. And the reason that I'm saying this is because this video, you can see it in the title, right? How do you carry a game where you've gotten absolutely rolled over? The game that I'm about to show you guys right now, you're not going to see my best gameplay. You're going to see me get demolished, okay? I'm not going to tell you whether or not it's a win or a loss. I'm just going to showcase to you guys... Like right here, obviously, stupid, you know, obviously, I'm not going to talk about anything with that. But this video is not going to talk about how I'm playing stupid like this. This video is going to be talking about what you can do in the absolute worst case scenario, especially as a top laner. This works for everything, but especially as a top laner, if you're literally running it down, like if you're 0-6, 0-7, 1-8, how do you still manage to do anything in the game, you know, because if you're 0-7, you're gonna be useless. So this little trick that I'm gonna talk about now, not trick, more playstyle, what I'm gonna talk about now is mostly gonna work on champions that have some sort of potential to 1v1. Like, you know, for example, Narcissus is very good, Yasuo would be very good, Fiora would be very good, Jax would be very good, Garen would be very good. All of these sort of strong independent champions would be good with this type of strategy. So, first of all, we're going to look at what happens in the earlier stages of the game. I'm getting it. It's a bit cold, so I'm just going to put this on. We're going to look at what happens. I'm, of course, going to get demolished by this guy. Because, like, I just played a horrible game. But, like, in the later stages of the game, you're going to see what I do to still provide a very big amount of value as a player that has like a score of, I don't remember what it was, 0-7, 1-8, whatever the hell it was. So first of all, the main thing, split pushing. However, you're not going to split push like an idiot. It's more complicated than you may think. You're going to split push. You're going to apply pressure and you will be able to 1v1 most champions. If you stay behind and fall behind, of course you can't. You know, if there is a difference between a player that's 0-7 and super behind, and a player that's 0-7 and only like 1,000 or 2,000 gold behind. There's a difference between these two. I want to bring you from this one to this one, okay? So number one, you want to split push, you want to take minions, you want to do that. Sometimes you cannot do that. What do you do instead? You invade the enemy jungle. See, this one, you can take a sweeper, you can take a control ward, you can take a normal ward, you can take whatever means you feel like you need and invade the enemy jungle. Right now, we're talking about you being 0-6, 0-5, 0-7. You know what I mean? If you're in that score count, you're going to take risks. I mean, what are you going to do otherwise? We're going to ignore what is happening right now. Obviously, I'm playing bad, right? Like, obviously. We're talking about you being 0-6. I'm actually going to ult the turret here. Reason being is I'm behind. I do not want to fight the Garen. You can already see kind of what I'm talking about right here. I'm using resources on things that may be as silly as two turret blades. Just to be able to maintain my gold. Like, if I didn't do that, I would get one turret blade. I essentially got 150 gold for my ultimate, which is worth it in this particular scenario. Because I want to remain at like a decent gold count, even though he's demolishing me. So what I was talking about is, you invade the jungle. You use any means possible to invade the jungle. Use the wards, use the sweeper, use the whatever. Like, even use ultimates, I swear to God, use everything to take the enemy jungle. And especially their buffs. So like, for example, as a Baron laner, you can be close to the blue buff or you can be close to the red buff. Let's say the enemy is roaming to the dragon and I'm playing Narcissus. I can literally ult the enemy red buff, clear his entire jungle, shove the wave. If I do that, I'm going to be generating huge amounts of gold, which is actually going to give me a strong late game, even if I'm like 0-7. And this is something very important, because like, so many people, when they're 0-7, like, their attitude is like, I'm afraid, I do not want to go 0-8. You know what I mean? Like, a lot of people, when they are 0-6, 0-7, they're just kind of afraid of people trash-talking them. Like, I am getting trash-talked this game. I'm literally getting trash-talked. But that's normal. If you're getting snowballed like this, people are going to start to trash-talk you, because humans are like that. You need to not be afraid. Contrary to that, you need to be even more aggressive in a way of like invading, taking turrets, making the plays, making these stupid plays that like basically work 30% of the times that you would normally not make, because you know you're not going to take that 30 to 70% risk. But if you're 0-7, you know what I mean, it's either 30% or 0%. Because if you do not do anything, you're just going to get rolled over by the enemy. You know what I mean? You're not going to be able to do anything if you just don't invade, if you don't do anything, if you don't push turrets, if you constantly rotate to your team as a 0-7 Nasus. What are you going to do? What are you going to do as a 0-7 Fiora? But if you split push, if you steal blue buffs, if you try to do objectives, if you try to do things, take turrets, push waves, everything like that, you're going to be able to generate a very decent amount of gold per minute, experience per minute. And even when you're at a very bad score, you're going to be able to, I mean, comeback, of course, yes. But if you're a 0-7, it's a bit problematic. But what I mean is you're going to be able to provide value. You know, you're either going to be tanky in a team fight, as if you're Fiora, you're going to be able to 1v1 people, even if you're 0-7. If you're playing, I don't know, like whatever, if you're playing Kazadin, you can farm up and be able to still do something in the late game. Everything has its value. Look at what I'm doing right here. Very quickly taking care of the Rift Herald and now instantly leaving the lane probably. I'm going to go to bot lane, clear that wave. I'm ulting here just to try to not die. Actually, seems like it's... I killed him. There we go. Very nice. Actually, very nice. That was very nice. That was a very nice preemptive ultimate. I'm probably going to die here. I'm going to try to kill her, but she flashes to me. That electrocute caught me, man. But that was actually fine. Also, obviously, another thing you need to keep in mind of, if you're like 0-7, I mean, in my case, I'm not 0-7, but I'm getting destroyed. It's always worth to trade your life for another enemy. Because, I hate to say it like this, but if you're like very low score, you're worth less than a champion. So, trading yourself for an enemy champion, doesn't even matter who it is going to give your team a better chance at victory. 5v5 is going to be, like for us, 5v5 is going to be worse than a 4v4. If I take Tristana with me, Kha'Zix, whoever the hell I take with me, it's going to be good for my team, rather than going for a 5v5. And look at this, look at this. You see how I am 1-on-3, but I'm still fighting Tristana? That is because I know the value of my champion, look. And I'm taking the risk. See, this is what I mean. I'm not 0-7. I am not 0-7. But I am comparable to being 0-7. I have gotten absolutely destroyed in lane. And you'll see, this game is going to get very bad for me. Very bad. I think I'm going to die like 5 times in a row now. So, you need to know the powers of your champion, whether it's taking jungle fast, whether it's 1v1s, whether it is teamfights. Because some champions, you know, I'm talking about split pushing, but if we look at Malphite, for example, you ain't going to split push on Malphite. With Malphite, I hate to say it, but even if you're 0-6, you're going to teamfight. You're literally going to teamfight. And I know you're going to die fast. But as a Malphite, you have value somewhere else. Your value lies in teamfighting. You just want to hit that ultimate. You just want to hit that Malphite third ability on the enemy ADC to reduce his attack speed. You just want to do something. Okay? Because I get so sick and tired of Malphites that split push. Malphite is not a split pusher. You know, all the talk I've been doing in this video for like the first 8 minutes is it has been about split pushing, invading jungle, etc. Malphite cannot do that. There's other champions that cannot do that either. You have to play towards your individual champion. So for example, Yone, for example, you're behind on Yone. What do? You invade the enemy jungle. You need to remember, especially, Yone has his third ability. He can very easily invade, take something and jump right back over the wall. He has his ultimate to jump away in case he needs it. So as a Yone, you can invade jungle. There's one more thing you can also do as a Yone if you're, we're talking 0-7. Dive the enemy backline. You can flank the enemy. There's a lot of things you can do that work on champions, even if you're very behind. Now, I do also hate to say that there are some champions where you're just pretty much screwed on. For example, if you're behind on Master Yi, you are absolutely screwed. You need to power farm. If you're behind on Katarina, you're even more screwed. Because Katarina cannot take jungle. She can only farm lanes. Yeah, for that one, you're actually kind of screwed. What can I say? You just need to try to farm minions, which is incredibly hard to get fed with. Here, I tried to provide some sort of value in a team fight, and I actually did. You know what I mean? I did. It was a good moment to rotate. But now I need to go back to farming. I should probably go to top lane or to bot lane just to farm. But it seems like I actually wanted to help my team here to apply some pressure to the mid lane. But the question is this really worth it? Yeah, as you can see, I am indeed going. No, don't go to the Drake. No. Okay, yeah, yeah. Pushing mid lane is good. See, pushing mid lane is good. I can, again, I can easily outtrade Tristana. I know my value. Like, I know the value of Nasus. Even if I'm behind, I know the value of my champion. I'm, of course, not stepping too far to let her stack her lethal tempo. I'm dead. I'm dead. Yep, I'm dead. I did step too far. So here's where we're gonna get into the moment where I'm gonna die like 5 times in a row. Here's where I'm really gonna, you know, fall behind. Because the very early stages of the game, you may be thinking, they're going fine. But I want to remind you, I'm 2,200 gold behind the Garen. And I'm gonna die like 3 more times, I think. So it's gonna get bad. It's gonna get bad. And you're gonna have to see what I'm gonna try to do to deal with it. And it's about trying. And you know, I can tell you as much as I want, you're still gonna lose majority of the games while you're 0-7. Like, it's not like this video is gonna be a magical thing for you that's gonna win every game for you where you're, even if you're 0-7. No, that's not the truth. This video is gonna give you the best tools to increase your chances to potentially make a comeback in a scenario that seems hopeless, which is that 0-7 scenario. You know what I mean? 0-8, whatever the hell your score is, 2-1-8. It's hopeless, right? It's like, these are hopeless scenarios. And applying the things I've been talking about, like with Nasus, for example, he takes wave very fast. He takes turrets very fast. And especially the turret taking for Nasus in particular, the hard thing about this is each champion has their things. Yone has very slow turret taking. Yasuo, very slow turret taking. But these two champions, very fast jungle, very fast wave pushing. So you can push multiple waves, you can invade multiple jungles, but cannot take turrets. You can take turrets, but it's not fast. But Nasus, like, look right here. If I had my ult, I would have ran down the turret, probably. I would have just suicided for the turret. And you also need to know you have no value. So trading enemies is worth it, but also trading your life for a turret is likely worth it. Even trading your life for the... Like, if you're actually 0-7, trading your life for the entire blue jungle is also worth it. I swear to God. Like, more often than not, if you're so, like, such a bad score, just deny enemy jungle and you're actually just doing something. You know what I mean? I don't like what I'm doing here. It's like, look at how little damage I have. To be fair, on the Kha'Zix, I am doing decent damage, but I should be shoving waves. I need to apply pressure. No idea why I'm trying to team fight right here. I need to shove this wave. Just shove the wave. I'm a little bit late with it, though. My mana also ran out. I'm probably gonna die here. Yeah, I'm probably dead. I think I knew I was dead. So, what am I gonna do? Nice dodge, but I'm probably still dead. Yeah. There's like 4 people roaming on me. I flashed to try to waste time. But as I said, this is not going to be the best game for me. I'm not afraid to show you guys, of course. I also want to remind you guys about... Look, Yone invading enemy jungle. Beautiful. You see? This is actually part of the plan. Like, I waste their time. Yone perfectly capitalized on this. By invading... Perfect. You see, this is how you make a comeback. This is what you can do to make a comeback. Yone is invading their jungle. The power of invading is so big in Wild Rift, and it's so heavily underrated. Because not only are you getting gold, you are denying gold from the enemies too. Like, the enemy cannot take it. He did die for it though, which doesn't make it worth it, unfortunately. That's the problem. You should have just backported. I wanted to say something. Oh yeah. The skin giveaway, guys. I'm giving away 3 skins this month. I picked winners for last month, by the way. There's only 1 winner that hasn't claimed their skins yet. But it's funny, I already did gift 3 skins. So if you wanna enter the skin giveaway, just put down a comment under the video. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a like. Wait, I wanna check. Did the last video reach 1,000? No, never mind. I uploaded the last video a couple hours ago, as of now. So not sure if it will reach 1,000 likes. But we still have the 1,000 like streak going. But let's focus on the gameplay. Pushing lane, look. I'm looking on the map. 3 people and 2 are dead. What does this mean? Free turret. Free real estate. Taking down the towers. I'm probably gonna ult the tower. Am I gonna ult the tower? I probably am. Boom and ult. It seems like I'm not ulting the tower. Maybe I wanted to save my ult for if someone rotates on me or something. Or for the next tower. Maybe I suicided for this tower. No, never mind. Never mind. I'm just dead. If I dodge the hook, okay. My team is pinging me a lot. Garen solo dragon. Oh my god. Again, here I'm just trying to waste time and... Like you can see, this is all I can do. This is all I can do right now. Oh, it's really unfortunate we lost the dragon. Because like the idea was, I apply pressure here. My team takes dragon. Unfortunately, my team did not actually go for the dragon. And they somehow let the Garen solo the Drake by himself. Which is kind of weird to me, but it is what it is. But as I said, I'm going to get a very low score this game. We're at 2-7. I think it's going to get even worse than this, the score. But then we're going to start to see some very weird strategies that I'm doing. Like, very weird things. And I'm going to tell you, you're going to feel very uncomfortable playing like this. Like, very, very uncomfortable if you play like this. I cannot 1v1 Garen. I should, like, come on. Come on. I think this is my next death. Yes, because I thought I can 1v1 Garen with a Trinity Force. Are you kidding me? You can see how dumb I was in this game. I mean, look at how much damage his ult is gonna do. Look. It did 1500 true damage. I think this is gonna be my last death. I think this is where it ends. Because obviously I was being stupid here. I kind of, like, normally Gnassus wins 1v1 against Garen, but you only win with a Divine Sunderer. That's the problem. I did not have a Divine Sunderer. The annoying thing, though, is, of course, when you're, like, so... When you have such a bad score, the morale of the team is always gonna be trash. Like, they're always going to be trash-talking you, they're always going to be tilting, they're going to be annoyed, all of that. So, that's the annoying thing. I suggest you to either mute everyone or try to be nice to everyone and be like, we guys can do this, blah, blah, blah. But probably muting people is better, because humans are very, very toxic individuals. I can provide value here by slowing him. After that, I'm probably not going to care about this dragon. Like, I probably do not want to roam to this dragon. Now we've killed two of them. So maybe I could, but like I always, like my champion is a turret pusher. Gnassus is a turret pusher and a team fighter, true. But because I'm so behind, probably going to be better as a turret pusher. I do actually have a lot of stacks on my first ability though. Like considering I'm 2-8, I actually do have a lot of stacks. So as you can see, I'm going to apply a lot of, oh, I can slow him. I did not reach him. That's very sad. Very nice. Pantheon got a kill. That's huge. Like, I just know I'm not gonna be able to provide any value. My team is actually doing very well. This is very good for us. I'm just gonna keep pushing. I'm literally gonna keep pushing. As long as I can keep one... Like, the thing is, you need to know, even if you die, as long as you can keep one person busy, it's worth it. Because you are useless. Like, I'm literally useless here. I collapsed on them because that was an opportunity. But as long as you can keep one enemy busy, it's worth it. Because your team is going to be able to four, like my team will win 4v4s. But I am so useless this game that a 5v5 is bad for our team. I do not want a 5v5 to happen. Because of myself. Because of me being so useless. I can suicide for this turret here, but I guess I'm not going to do it. Because we have Elder Dragon. Like I'm actually kind of strong with the Elder Dragon, so I'm not suiciding. Yet again, I'm trying to stop them. I'm trying to waste their time. Like, I'm not with my team here. Need to be a bit careful here, but yeah, I'm fine. And here we go, the jungle invade as well. The jungle spawns? Of course I'm gonna take the jungle. Denying them gold as well. Just being super annoying. I'm so useless, but I'm taking their farm. You know what I mean? Like, I'm taking their farm. Got my Amaranth Twinger too. Now I can potentially team fight too. But I'm probably going to be split pushing. I'm probably going to be split pushing. Because again, my team is going to try to fight. I don't want to be there during the fight. You just want to be away from a team. Unless you're like a Malphite. Remember that one. Like, you have some champions where even if you're like 0-8, you still want to be there in the fight. Oh no. Oh no. But this is obviously the risk. Three of my teammates died. This is obviously the risk of this type of playstyle. It's not all sugar and candies. It's obviously the risk. Here I was thinking, red buff or turret? I'm just gonna take the turret, as you can see. They're trying to end the game. What do I do? You know, what do I do in this situation? I can kill the pike. We have Baron. They're trying to end the game. We have Baron though. I'm not hesitating. I know what I'm doing. I know what I need to do as a Narciss. I know what I need to do. And that's the sudden ending of the video. That's the sudden ending of the game. That's the sudden ending of the day for me today. And I'll be heading to bed. I don't want to use an insult to myself, but obviously I played trash. But I really hope this very weird video kind of gave you a sense of how even if you're giga useless, you can still do something nice in the game. So I thank you guys so much for watching. Really hope you enjoyed the video. I will see you all in the next Wild Rift video. Bye bye. Oh, I didn't click on the buy button. Let's now click on the buy button.